Praise God. I want to welcome you to this week's Abundance Grace Hour. This week we shall be talking and we shall be starting the series that talks about divine favor. Divine favor. What is divine favor? How can you get divine favor? What are the benefits to divine favor? We get straight to this after this short break. Grace to go for it again. God Almighty will give to you in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, welcome back. So, divine favor. What is divine favor? Looking at the two words, you know, you discover that it combines divine and favor. Divine is something that comes from above, that comes from only God. And of course, favor is God smiling at you. It's you having smile of God over anything you are doing. Our text today is going to be from the book of Esther. Esther chapter 5, and I will read from verse 1 to 3. Esther 5, 1 to 3. Now it came to pass on the third day that Esther put on her royal apparel and stood in the inner court of the king's house over against the king's house. And the king sat upon his royal throne in the royal house over against the gate of the house. And it was so, when the king saw Esther, the queen, standing in the court, that she obtained favor in his sight. And the king held out to Esther the golden scepter that was in his hand. So Esther drew near and touched the top of the scepter. Then said the king unto her, "What wilt thou, Queen Esther, and what is thy request? It shall be given unto thee, even up to half of my kingdom." Even up to half of my kingdom. If you are a Christian, and of course you are a Bible scholar or a student of Bible, you must be very familiar with this story. In this land, at this particular time, it was not allowed for a queen, you know, to see the king without prior invitation. But Queen Esther took it upon herself, because there was a problem in the land, and she stepped in, and of course she broke the protocol, and ordinarily she's supposed to die, but she obtained favor from the sight of the king. So that is what we're talking about. When your mistakes are being overlooked, when your error are being overlooked, that is favor. You know, when God smiles at your work, when God smiles at your business, when your relationship is enjoying the smiling of God, that is divine favor. When you are being selected, when you are being preferred, you know, among your peers, among your colleague, you know, in your place of work, all you need is just favor to be promoted above your colleagues. You know, there are different situations where people complain about the problems they are having at their work, the business, not thriving, not succeeding, student failing. All you need is divine favor. You know, when God just smiles at you, that is it. That is it. And I release upon you today grace to be favored by God, grace to be favored by men, grace for the land where you live in to favor you in the mighty name of Jesus. So let's continue our teaching, you know, as we dive deep into favor. We have defined favor as God smiling at you. You know, God's favor, divine favor, is God's good face on you. You know, when you are on a good book of God, that is divine favor. That is divine favor. Do you remember people that have that kind of favor around you? You know, have you ever been to the store or to the mall and you see 5-10 people selling the same thing? And you pass the first one, you pass the second one, you pass the third one, and you go to almost the 8th person. Or maybe you are surfing online. I mean, I do that a lot. And you just type in something online, and you see number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, and you don't click on any of those, you go to number 9. That is divine favor. That is divine favor right there. You know, I believe in most cases, you have seen situations whereby you look at a lady, maybe very beautiful, and you see the husband, maybe absolutely beautiful also. And you'll be wondering, how come? How did this kind of woman, you know, marry this kind of a man? It's divine favor, people of God. Is divine favor. So we shall be diving deep into this series. The favor we are talking about was upon Jesus Christ himself. You know, Bible says, and Jesus grew in stature and obtained favor from God and even from men. You know, this type of favor we are talking about was upon Joseph. You know, Joseph was in the prison, and to the extent that the prison warder, the prison keeper, gave Joseph the key to the prison to keep. Can you imagine that? A prisoner holding the key to the jail. That is favor we are talking about right there. You know, David had that kind of a favor, you know, among his brethren when Prophet Samuel went to Jesse's house to anoint one of his sons. And of course, Jesse, that is David's father, brought all David's brothers out, but they forgot about David. They forgot about David, but favor located him. I don't know where you are in your life right now. All you need is just divine favor. Maybe you have been forgotten. Maybe in your marriage you have been forgotten. Maybe in your business, people don't even know that you are opening that shop. They don't even know that you sell that thing. They don't even know. Maybe you submit an application, you've submitted your resume, and it seems that you have been forgotten. All you need, my brother, all you need, my sister, is divine favor of God. Divine favor of God. So what are the benefits of divine favor? Number one is you receive support from God Almighty. You know, God begins to support you in anything you do. It will look as if you are the only person that knows how to do it. You know, if maybe you are a student, either you study or you don't study, you just see yourself passing. And that is not an enthusiastic for you not to study. You know, but I'm just telling you that in anything you do, you begin to receive God's support. God begin to back you up. You know, in battles of life, God begin to support you. And I prophesy and I decree to your life, in every area of your life, I pray that you will begin to receive divine favor in the mighty name of Jesus. Wow! I hope you'll be mightily blessed from today's ministration. I'm so glad that you are here. And tell you what, we do not take this time for granted at all. We would like to hear from you. Share your testimony with us on our website, www.rccgage.org. You can also post on our Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and you can also follow us on Instagram. And if you happen to live in our neighborhood, we would like to have you worship with us. We are located at 3226 Pioneer Road, Suite C, Boss Spring, Texas, 75180. Until next time, on Abundant Grace Hour, remember, His grace is sufficient for you.